Yeah, children, moving to the next definition, chiral. What is chiral? Chiral is nothing but a property. Suppose I have an object. This object is non-superimposable on its mirror image. Then I am going to call that object as chiral object. And this property is called as chirality. So what is chirality? Chirality is a property by which an object is non-superimposable on its mirror image. Okay, it will not be able to superimpose on its mirror image. Then this property is called as chirality, and the particles or objects which exhibit the property of chirality is called as chiral compounds. Okay, what are enantiomers? We have seen what are stereoisomers. Stereoisomers, different spatial arrangement. Now what are enantiomers? Enantiomers or stereomers, which is non-superimposable on its mirror image, is called as enantiomers. You know what is chiral? No, just replace the term object with the stereoisomers, then you will be knowing what is enantiomers. Okay, clear? So what are enantiomers? Enantiomers or stereomers, which is stereoisomers or stereomers. Stereoisomers, which is non-superimposable on its mirror image, is called as enantiomers. Okay, I have one more property for enantiomers. See, enantiomers is able to rotate the plane polarized light to same extent. But what happens? The direction of rotation is different. They rotate in different direction. Okay, so what are enantiomers? Enantiomers are nothing but stereomers, which is non-superimposable on its mirror image. They too rotate the plane polarized light to the same extent as that of stereoisomers. But what is the difference? Enantiomers will be rotating the plane polarized light in the direction opposite to that of stereoisomers. Done. Now, what is a racemic mixture? What is a racemic mixture? See, equimolar mixture of pair of enantiomers is called as racemic mixture. I have a pair of enantiomers. See, when these pair of enantiomers are in equal proportion, then I am going to call that mixture as racemic mixture. Now, this racemic mixture is optically inactive because it has both positive rotation and a negative rotation. So, it will be compensated by external compensation. They cross out, okay? Positive and negative cross out. So, as a result, they will be optically inactive. So, what are racemic mixture? Equimolar mixture of pair of enantiomers. They are optically inactive. Why they are optically inactive? Because they are compensated externally. Done. What is racemization? I have enantiomers. The process of converting enantiomers to racemic mixture is called as racemization. So, racemic mixture is a mixture having a pair of enantiomers. Racemization is a process by which your enantiomers are converted to racemic mixture. So, I have told you racemic mixture. I have told you what is racemization. Then, what is resolution of racemic mixture? Resolution, separating. Okay. I'm going to separate the racemic mixture into individual enantiomers as dextrorotatory compounds and levorotatory compounds is called as resolution of racemic mixture. Children, I can otherwise tell your resolution of racemic mixture is just the opposite of your racemization. Am I correct? Because racemization means you are joining the enantiomers to give you racemic mixture. Okay. I have a pair of enantiomers like E1 and E2. When I am going to convert this E1 and E2 to racemic mixture, then that is called as racemization. What is the resolution of racemic mixture? From racemic mixture, I am going to separate the enantiomers as dextrorotatory and levorotatory. So, racemization and resolution are opposite to one another in their way of process. Okay. Then what is mesocompounds? Mesocompounds are compounds with two or more chirality centers. You know what is chiral? They are non-superimposable on its mirror images. So, mesocompounds are compounds. They have two or more chirality centers. But you know, they have an achiral molecular structure having a plane of symmetry. But they are optically inactive. Why are they optically inactive? Here they are compensated internally. They are crossed out internally. So, meso compounds have two or more chirality centers. They too have a chiral molecular structure. They have plane of symmetry. They are optically inactive. They are compensated internally. Done. Clear? So you need to remember 4 points under meso compounds. So what are meso compounds? Compounds having two or more chirality center. They have a chiral molecular structure. They have plane of symmetry. They are optically inactive. Why? Because the positive and the negative signs are compensated internally. Next is diastereomers. We have seen stereomers, we have seen enantiomers, we have seen chirality. Then diastereomers. See, diastereomers are also non-superimposable. There is no mirror image relationship here. Okay. Like I was telling for chiral, they are non-superimposable on its mirror image. Your diastereoisomers are also non-superimposable but not related to the mirror images. Okay. Next is, what is retention? See, retention is nothing but optically active molecule. See, I have an optically active molecule. It has atoms or molecules, atoms or groups around the chiral center. Now, when the reaction proceeds, the reactant distribution of atoms and groups will be same as that of product. Then I am going to call that as retention of configuration. From the reactant, it has retained the configuration. So it is called as retention of configuration. I am repeating, an optically active molecule has atoms or groups around a chiral center. This orientation or this arrangement or this configuration of atoms and groups is the same before the reaction and after the reaction. So what did I mean? Before the reaction proceeds, I'll be having only reactants. Once the reaction has proceeded, I'll be having product. So the product and the reactant have same configuration of atoms and groups around the chiral center. So what I say, the product is retaining the configuration of the reactant. So it remains same. This is called as retention of configuration. Now what is opposite to this? Inversion. Now what is opposite to this? Inversion. Inversion means what? I have an optically active compound. I have atoms or groups in a chiral center. The configuration of atoms and groups will be opposite before the reaction and after the reaction. Or otherwise I can tell you, in reactant, the arrangement of atoms and groups is opposite to that of product. Means before the reaction and after the reaction, they are different. They are not able to retain the configuration. What they have done? They have inverted it. So this is called as inversion. Am I clear? So retention is having same configuration of atoms and groups before and after the reaction. And what is inversion? Inversion is nothing but opposite to the opposite of configuration of atoms and groups for the reactants and the products. Okay, children. Children, moving to the last part. There are three outcomes for an asymmetric carbon atom. I have already explained you what is asymmetrical carbon atom. What is asymmetrical carbon atom? Carbon atom surrounded by four different groups is called as asymmetrical carbon atom. When I have an asymmetrical carbon atom, then I have three possible outcomes. I will be getting three products. I will get A, B or AB. I am going to explain that. So what is the first step? Replacement of group X by group Y. I need to remove X and I have to place Y. So for that, I have a structure here. C2H5CH3YH. See, I have a carbon atom here. It is unshown. Am I correct? See, this carbon atom is attached by four different groups. What are the four different groups? C2H5CH3H and Y. Before that, already in class 11, we have seen what is this solid wedge represents. This solid wedge represents the bond which is projecting from the paper. And what does this dashed line represent? This is going to represent the plane which is going down the paper. The plane which is going down the paper. This is from class 11. I'm just giving a sum up. And what does the straight line indicate? The straight line is going to represent the bond in the plane of paper. So straight line representing bond in the plane of paper. dashed line going down the plane of paper and solid wedge bond projecting from the plane of paper. So I have indicated my asymmetrical carbon atom. Now what happens in step 1? I what did I tell you? Replace Y with X. So I have removed this Y and I have added X here. Am I correct? I have removed Y and I have added X. I have added X here. Then what can be the third step? What can be the third step? See, this is compound B. What is this? This is B. And what is this? This is compound A. See, compound A, when you see the configuration, they have, before that I have told you about two different terms, you know that, retention and inversion. What is retention of configuration? Having a same configuration of atoms and group before and after the reaction. This is retention of configuration. Am I correct? This is going to retain the same configuration as that of your reactant. Now, what is this, children? This is inversion of configuration. And I have got the product A and B. In what ratio I have got? I have got in the ratio 50-50. Means what? This is a racemic mixture. It has got both the dextrorotatory and the levorotatory in the proportion 50:50. So this is an optically inactive molecule. I have told you about optically inactive molecule. There are two ways why it has become optically inactive. One, external crossover. I mean externally crossing down its charges, or internal crossing down of its charges. Here your A plus B is nothing but your racemic mixture, because it has got equal 50-50 proportion of your dextrorotatory compound and levorotatory compound. It is optically inactive. Why? Because one isomer is going to rotate the light to the direction opposite to that of other. Okay, so one isomer, say for example D isomer, is going to rotate the plane polarized light in a direction which is opposite to that of R. Okay children, we have seen haloalkenes, classification, physical properties, chemical properties. In chemical properties, try to remember the important reactions like Wood's reaction, and in preparation you have to remember Frankel-Stein's reaction and Swartz reactions. Then Sandmeyer reaction. These are important for haloalkenes. Then in haloarenes, preparation we have seen. Then we saw physical properties. Then we saw chemical properties. So haloalkenes, as far as considered, nucleophilic substitution. Haloarenes, as far as considered, you have to concentrate on electrophilic substitution. In haloarene, which naming reaction is very important? Dow's reaction is very, very important. And then we have seen about the stereoisomers, we have seen about the chirality, then we saw plane polarized light, we saw optical activity, then we saw about meso compounds, we saw diastereoisomers, then we saw asymmetric carbon atom, what are the three possible ways, then we saw retention, and we saw what is inversion. So what is the last two topics which is left out, three topics are left out in the chapter. One is SN1. Substitution for haloalkanes, SN2 substitution for haloalkanes or alkyl halides. Then test to determine your halogen containing compounds, then polyhalogen compounds. Thank you, children.